Hey guys, it's Austin from Greenlink here. Today we're going to go over a quick rundown on blower doors. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get into it. So when we do a blower door test, we're measuring the air infiltration of a building. Our objective is simple. Set up the blower door, run the test properly, and document the results.
All right, we've got a few key components to our blower door. There's about six or seven different pieces that we need when we're running a blower door test. We've got two side rails, two top rails, which you can identify by the miter edges on them. And then we've got a middle rail, which is the support for our fan. We've got our blower door cover. We've got our manometer, which is the most important piece to this. We've got our holder here for our manometer along with the power cords, and then our blower door fan itself. So we're going to go ahead and start to get this set up, and we'll go from there. And one of the really important pieces to this is the cam locks right here. We need to make sure these are facing up.
Let's set up the unit. Build the frame and set up the fan in the front door.
We want to have our frame on the outside of the jamb of the door stop. And we're gonna slide this in, start to expand it. Now I'm gonna start to tighten my cam. So I've got my very first one here. Wanna make sure these cams are also not locked in either. As we pull this, it starts locking into place. We don't need that right now. We just wanna tighten this wing nut so now this top piece can't slide. And we'll do that all the way around all four sides. Okay, now we've got our door all locked in. As you see, it doesn't collapse on itself anymore. And we'll get our cover set up here. This cover should be laid down flat. And we lay it down. We want to be somewhat gentle with this when we're throwing the frame around. I like to start at the bottom side here. Pull this tight to get these Velcro tabs. We want to slide our blower door all the way to those tabs. Next, I do the sides. I like to save the top for last. Make sure everything's lined up the way we want it to be. Now we've got our door built. We're going to go ahead and set up a couple of our hoses here, make sure we have everything the way we need it. Typically we use the green hose as our reference hose to the outside. So what I like to do is go ahead and throw this outside before I set my door in. We need to make sure that the air is not blowing in this hose. Best thing to do is throw it to the side. Set it right in front of your door. Now we're going to set our frame into place. We've got our cams up here. Now we're gonna start to lock this in so I can feel that I'm pushed back all the way. Flip that lever, I can feel it getting tight, that's locked in. Do that around all four sides. Okay, we're in business. While I'm down here, I'm gonna go ahead and reach my reference hose. Pull that through this little bottom inlet. Now we're gonna grab our fan. Okay, as we're installing our fan, we need to make sure our cover's on. That's important to have on because we'll need that for our initial test. Okay, now we've got our door set up, our fan is installed. Now we've got our last horizontal brace, which this is actually missing a piece of Velcro. Typically, you'll see here in a second as we slide this in. Again, our cam is completely loose so we can adjust as needed. I like to kind of hold this with one hand. I'm pushing this thing tight and I'm locking my wing nut. Now I'm locking my cam. That's tight in there. So we have a Velcro piece. We could also use a bungee cord that goes around this and it just kind of wraps around this handle, secures this fan from moving around too much as we're running our test. For the purpose of demonstration today, we're going to go without that. But when we're missing pieces or components of our kit, we do need to get that addressed right away. Now we'll go ahead and hook up our hoses here. We've got our green hose, which goes to the A channel, which is the left side of the device, A channel, and B channel. So we want our green hose referencing the A channel port here. And then we're going to take our red hose, and this is going to go to the input side of the B channel. You don't want hoses dangling in front of this fan in case it sucks something in there and chops it up. Last piece here, we've got our power side here for our fan. Plug that into the receiver on the side of the fan here.
Make sure you prep the home too. Turn off the furnace, close all windows, put the water heater in standby mode, and make sure that the fireplace flue is closed and we're protected against any ash from pulling into the house. We're gonna go ahead and turn our manometer on and start to run our tests. First thing we do is hit the on button. I like to turn on the light. As you see here, we start off in pressure, PR-PR. We need to get into the proper mode, which is pressure slash flow at 50. So I'm gonna hit mode. Now that just changed me to pressure flow. I'm gonna hit mode again. Pressure flow at 50. Now we're in the right setting. So I hit mode twice to get to that setting. Now we need to do a baseline to zero out the difference between the outside air pressure and the pressure within the house. We can see here, we're in a control environment, so the pressure difference is zero. But if this was set up in a front door of a home, we would see this bouncing between -2, 3, maybe +2 or 3. Baseline start. Now we're running our baseline test. I generally like to let this go for about 10 seconds. Once we feel like we're good, we go ahead and hit enter. Now we've just zeroed out the difference between the inside pressure and the outside pressure. And we are good to go ahead and run our test. The first thing we'll do is we'll take off the cover off of our fan. We're gonna take this all the way out to be in our open setting. Something else that's important to understand is we have this configure button here. See at the top right, it says open. If I hit configure again, now it says A1. So if I want to run my A-ring on here, then I would have to change the configuration to A1. I can go to B, C, D, E, and back to open. So we're going to leave ours on open for right now, and we can go ahead and turn the blower door on. And as we're running this, we want to see our pressure get to a negative 50 pascals. That's very important to get to that number. If it flashes and says low or it can't get to that number, that's when we need to bring in our A ring or B ring because the house may be too tight for the open setting. Okay, here in the shop, we can't get to 50 pascals, that's fine. But you get the idea of what we're trying to accomplish here. And once you're done, make sure you get your photo of your test while it's running, and then we can get our manometer turned back off and start to break things back down.
If any parts are missing, notify your supervisor immediately and document that as well. But that's all you need to know for now. Set it up properly, document the results, and leave the home in better shape than you found it. And that just about covers it. We'll see you on the next one.